Good morning.
I've been looking forward to this chapel because it's dear to my heart what I'm going to teach you today. So to get started, let's say a prayer and ask God to help me and help you. Five fingers here, five fingers there, 10 little fingers folded in prayer. Dear Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for another day of life where we can love you and love the people you've put in our lives. Thank you, God, for the Bible and its instruction, its teaching to us about how to live. I pray so much, God, that I will live this lesson and that my little friends will listen and learn and put into practice what we're going to talk about today. Thank you for Jesus. Thank you for the Bible. Thank you for the Holy Spirit. In your name, amen.
Amen.
Okay, it's my turn to talk. So y'all remember to keep your bubbles and you can just look right up here so you're not distracted by your friends. First thing I'm going to answer, because I got lots of questions, is I just hurt my hand and my wrist a little bit. This is just a brace and I'm going to be fine. Maybe y'all can pray that I'll get better. That would sure make me happy. And I know God listens to you because he loves you so much. Well, today I'm going to teach you something out of the Bible. God's book, my favorite book. It's the Word of God that gives us life. And he teaches us how to live a good life. And in order to do that, we need to give our hearts to Jesus so he can help us. So if you'll stand up with me, we're going to sing a song. And it is, Give Your Hearts to Jesus. Okay, I know you probably know it, so sing with me.
Put your right hand in, put your right hand out. Put your right hand in and you shake it all about. You give your heart to Jesus and you turn yourself around.
That's what it's all about.
Put your left hand in, you put your left hand out. Put your left hand in and you shake it all about. You give your heart to Jesus and you turn yourself around.
That's what it's all about.
This lesson is hard to do, and Jesus to help us. We need Jesus to take our hearts and make it like His so that we can obey what God tells us. In the Bible, you know, the Bible is kind of like a chapter book. It has lots of little books inside of it. And in the book of Ephesians, in the New Testament, it tells us in chapter 4 what kind of words we are supposed to say. And God tells us that it's very important to say words that build each other up. Words like, I like you. Words like, please be my friend. Words like, sure, I'll share with you. And to like, your family, I love you. Those kind of words are called building up or encouraging words. Those are kind and life-giving words. Now, everybody look at me. This is important. In the Bible, you are going to be so surprised that God says this in the Bible. But He says our words have power. They have so much power. All eyes on me. You don't want to miss this. So much power. They have the power of life, or they have the power of death. Can you believe it? Our words have the power of life or the power of death. Now that makes me want to be very careful about the words that come out of my mouth. So these encouraging, building up words are very good. Do you think these are death words or life words? When you say, I love you, yes, I'll share, you're my friend, come and play with me, yes, I like to obey. What kind of words are those? Life-giving, very good, yes. But there are some words that sometimes sneak out of our mouths that are not encouraging, building up words. Guess what? They are death words. When we say, no, I'm not going to do that, or, oh my goodness, that is a death word. Or if you ever say, you're not my friend, or I don't want to play with you, or no, mommy, I'm not doing that. Oh my goodness, that's a death word. God says that's not the kind of words that people who really love Him are going to say. That's why we need His help to give our hearts to Him so He can help us. Now, when you say kind and loving words, it's like you're helping someone's heart be so smooth and beautiful. But if you say death words, like, no, don't sit by me. Oh, that's a death word. That hurts people's hearts. Or if you say, I don't like what you have on. My dress is a lot prettier. Oh my goodness. Death. That is terrible. So when we do that, God has a solution. Because sometimes in our sin, that's just anything we think, say, or do that makes God unhappy. Sometimes we say death words. But there is a remedy. There's something that can take care of that and heal it. And that is when we tell God that we're sorry and we ask Him for forgiveness, guess what? He always forgives and He helps us make things right again with the person that we hurt. We can go and say, I'm sorry I said that. I'm asking Jesus to help me be kinder, and He is helping me. And God forgives you every time. But if there's ever a time you say what the Bible in Ephesians 4 calls unwholesome trash words, sometimes we say trash words.
No, I don't like trash.
Like, I don't like trash words either. I have had a few escape out of my mouth, and I have gone to God and told Him I'm sorry, and He forgives me. But just remember this picture. When you say a trash word, say Mrs. Kaug asks me if I would like to sit with her at lunch, and I say, no, you're not really my friend. I'm going to sit with other people. What am I doing to her heart? Oh my goodness. Oh, it hurt her heart. And it was a trash word. That's what God does not want us to say. But if we accidentally do, and we tell God we're sorry, and we say, I want to make that right, and we go back to that person and tell them, I'm so sorry I acted like that. God is helping me. Guess what? That's like a sweet fragrance to God. It's like a sweet smell to Him. God calls that a sacrifice of worship, and it goes up into heaven, and it makes Him happy. And it makes our hearts happy so that we also feel good about the words that are coming out of our mouths. Now, remember that we need God's help to do that. We can't really do that all on our own. That's why it's important that we know what the Bible says and we pray and ask Him for help. Hey, I know a song about that. I think you might too. Stay where you are, but kind of get up on your tiptoes like this. Y'all know what song we're going to sing? Pearl does. Something that will help us is if we do this every day. Read your Bible, pray every day. Read your Bible, pray every day, and you'll grow, and you'll grow, and you'll grow. And we'll say kind words, but forget your Bible. Don't ever pray. Forget your Bible. Don't ever pray. And you'll shrink. And you'll shrink. Grandma, Grandpa, they would love to read God's word to you. You just ask them. That's how our spirit man grows. And not only does God say it makes him sad, it makes the people sad when you say mean things, it really makes us sad too. But God's word says that it grieves, it makes sad the Holy Spirit. And when you become a Christian, God gives you the Holy Spirit to help you live life. He lives inside of you. And we don't want to grieve him. We don't want to make him sad. So we want to say life-giving words. Now,